Hi, it's Kaylee. Before we jump into this lesson, make sure you already know how to evaluate expressions with one variable and feel comfortable using order of operations and identifying parts of algebraic expressions. There's lessons on each of those topics. But if you're ready now, then let's go. Let's just jump right in with an easy example to get our feet wet. This one says, evaluate 2g plus f when g is equal to 5 and f is equal to 9. First of all, what do you see in the first term? Yeah, this is our first term here. So we have 2 and g, so a product. And what's g? Yeah, g is a variable. And that means 2 is a coefficient. Good. And how about in our second term? We have f, and f is, that's right, also a variable. So if g and f are both variables, does that mean that they're the same thing? Nope. Just like we can differentiate numbers, like we know 3 and 7 are not the same because they look different, g and f are not the same because they look different too. Awesome. So now let's get to our steps. Step one, let's rewrite our expression in our own handwriting. So we have 2g plus f. Now step two, we do substitution. So whenever we see a g, we're going to replace it with 5. And wherever we see f, we're going to replace it with 9. So I'm going to say 2 using my parentheses, g is equal to 5, substitute that in, plus f is equal to 9. So I substitute that in. Awesome. Now I can start to simplify using order of operations. So the first thing I do is I multiply 2 times 5. That gives me 10. Plus my 9, and if I add 10 plus 9, I get 19. Awesome, so that is the answer. So this example is going to take it up a notch. It says, evaluate the expression xy plus 2 to the power of x minus y, where x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3. Whew, that looks tricky, huh? But let's do what we know. First step, we just rewrite the expression in our own handwriting. So we'll have the product x and y. So this is just multiplying two variables together plus an exponent where my variable x is the exponent minus the variable y. Okay, well, I have my given values for x and y. So I'm going to do substitution. Anywhere I see an x, I'm going to replace it with a 2. Anywhere I see a y, I'm going to replace it with a 3. So I'm going to use my parentheses here. X is 2, y is 3, plus 2 to the power of x, which is 2, minus y, which is 3. Perfect. So now I can start to evaluate this using order of operations, which means I start with my exponent. So I maintain 2 times 3, and then I'm adding, I can simplify here, 2 to the power of 2 is the same as 2 times 2, so that gives me 4 minus 3. Perfect. Now my next order of operations, I can do this multiplication. So 2 times 3, that'll give me 6 plus 4 minus 3. And now when I'm doing arithmetic, I just go from left to right, so I can say 6 plus 4, that's going to be 10 minus 3, and that will give me 7. So our answer here is 7. Are you wondering when we will ever need to evaluate expressions with two variables? I know, me too. But there are actually a lot of formulas in science that have two unknowns. An unknown is another way of saying variable. Let's check one out. Automotive engineers run a lot of safety tests to ensure that cars are safe for people to drive in, even in the worst case scenario, a car crash. One of the tests these engineers do is to drive a car into a wall at a high speed and calculate the amount of force exerted on the wall. They can calculate the force using an equation. Force equals mass times acceleration, where the mass is the mass of the car and the acceleration is the acceleration of the car. We can simplify this formula by using variables, so it looks like F equals ma. So let's calculate the force of a car with a mass of 1,500 kilograms traveling with an acceleration of 4 meters per second squared. So let's start working this out by writing down our formula. We have F is equal to ma. And we know m and a are both variables, right? The mass of a car could be different for big cars or small cars, and the acceleration could be different. The car could be traveling faster or slower. But in this case, we know we have those given values for m and a, so we can use substitution. So let's plug it in. We know that the mass is equal to 1,500 kilograms, and the acceleration is 4 meters per second squared. Now it's okay if you don't totally understand how these units work yet, that'll come later. And now all we have to do is multiplication. So 1,500 times 4 is equal to 6,000. So the force is going to be equal to 6,000, and these units turn to newtons. So the automotive engineers would know that the force exerted on this wall right here is going to be 6,000 newtons. And then they can calculate how much damage will happen to the car and if the driver will be in danger. That's pretty crazy stuff, right? All from just using two variables. Great job evaluating expressions with two variables. You're ready to practice on your own. You can always use those three simple steps to help you. Have fun and remember to be clever. Hey.